Everybody, it's Invicta, and I want to make a video really quickly covering today's patch notes for December 20th, 2017. As always, for these newsy-type videos, you can find a link down below to the official posting on Blizzard's website. And this patch is quite the earthshaker, no pun intended, total pun intended there, in regards to Garrosh, which I'm sure you've already seen from the thumbnail, and I'll talk about him in a moment. But again, as always, you can pause this video at any time. I'm not going to be reading everything word for word, but if you'd like to do it at your own leisure or your own pace, you can simply pause this video or go to the official link in the description for the Blizzard posting. Now let's hop right onto it here, and there's a lot of balance changes that are not surprising. To be quite honest, I sort of called this one on stream not that long ago in regards to the over-tweaking of the supports that Blizzard did, and it's not really all that surprising to see them do a little bit of a pullback and give a buff to certain healers that weren't necessarily doing all that great with the whole healing revamp that they did not that long ago. So, Hanzo, your Dragon Strike, this is our ability. It's basically going to be turning into a little bit more of a powerful ability there. The base damage is getting increased by 6. Not that big of a deal, but Hanzo, of course, is still in need of some changes, in my opinion anyway, with his mobility, but his damage is certainly part of that. It's a very contentious time for people who play Hanzo but are wanting him to get more powerful and that sort of thing. So Dragon Strike getting a little bit of a damage buff is going to help out a little bit there. We'll see what else kind of tuning they do as Hanzo keeps on going. He's the newest one. I mean, he's the newest hero in Heroes of Storm. We haven't seen a 7-day nerf yet, so I guess that's a good sign. But definitely a little bit under tweak there for the damage on Hanzo for Dragon Strike. Going on to Nova. Nova getting a little bit of a slap on the wrist here. She has been way too strong. And I have a feeling another certain stealthy blonde lady whose name might kind of rhyme with Basmira is also going to be getting hit pretty darn hard. But let's talk about Nova really quickly. I'm not going to speculate stuff that's not here. Nova, her health getting reduced is a little bit of a noodle scratcher because she isn't really all that tanky anywhere. Or her survivability has never been about how much HP she has. It's always been about how fast she can get out of a bad situation and the fact that she does not have any mobility. So you have to pursue and follow through that every time that you expose a Nova player. You need to take them out. So I was a little bit surprised to see them actually reduce her HP. That's basically on par with Tracer, and that is a little bit scary. So Nova's going to have to be even more careful. I mean, you might think that 50 HP is not that big of a deal, but from a base level, that is kind of a big deal. That's a pretty big drop in her HP. Her health regen has been reduced a little bit. Not that big of a deal, in my opinion. Now, going on to Snipe here, the base damage has been reduced by 10. That is a big-time nerf to the Q ability of Nova, as that has been somewhat of another point of contention for a lot of people going up against the new stealthies in the game. So I think that this was a warranted change as far as Snipe is concerned, because of the fact that she can her base kit now with Snipe now allows her to chain sniping abilities and to gain more and more power as your accuracy improves with Snipe. So making sure that you land those big shots, or you're going to get rewarded with a lot of punishing damage. But obviously a lot of people, including Blizzard, felt that there was a little bit too punishing, so they're going to scale that back a little bit. But I think that this was a good change overall for Nova. Then level 16 lethal decoy. Hollow decoy damage bonus had been reduced from 50 to 40%. That was something that just needed to happen. I'm not exactly sure why Blizzard decided that they were going to put 10% of her damage into the decoy anyway, at the base level anyway, but there you go. Now, Thrall, good old Thrall, Green Jesus himself, he's going to be getting a little bit of help on the basic attack damage, getting increased by a whole lot. That 8 base damage is going to be pretty darn nice for anyone running AA builds or even Wind Fury builds for Thrall. And then level 13 Spirit Shield, the cooldown reduction has been increased from 8 to 10 seconds for Frostwolf Resilience. So Thrall getting some buffs. Good job, Thrall. We're happy for you. On to Nazebro Duncanstan. A little bit of help here for the Corpse Spiders, along with Ravenous Spirit, and the Gargantuan did get a little bit of a nerf there. Not that big of a deal, because, I mean, who really focuses the Gargantuan anyway, unless Nazebo leaves it out there to die. But there you go on that. I was actually surprised to see a little bit of a buff to the Corpse Spiders. I already felt that they were pretty darn strong, but a little bit of a tweak there from 2 damage. Later on, that can't, especially in the mid-game stages to late-game stages, that damage buff is not going to help out that much anymore. But early game, before that, it is going to be pretty significant, so you have to be a little bit more careful around Nazebo. And then, of course, the Ravenous Spirit, always my pick of the litter as far as the heroics go for Nazebo. I like the fact that they are still looking at that. Pretty cool. Now, Hexcrawlers, the health mana return has been increased by 0.25%, not that big of a deal. It is nice that he is going to get a little bit more dependability out of the survivability of going for the spider build, and I kind of like that. And then Vile Infection, the damage bonus has been reduced because those basic attacks were doing a whole lot of damage, and a lot of people were not happy about that, including myself, as Vile Infection did do a lot of damage if you ended up taking that at level 20. But overall, good changes for Nazebro Duncan Stan. On to Alexstrasza. Lifebinder getting a little bit of love because Blizzard realizes that Cleansing Flame is just far superior, in my opinion. So they're doing a little bit of adjusting there. Cleansing Flame did get a little bit of a damage nerf and a cooldown nerf, but not that big of a deal, 10 seconds. The bigger story for Alexstrasza is the reduction of the duration for Dragon Queen that's tied into Draconic Discipline. Now, this is one that you saw in Soul Keyciliness not that long ago, and I'm really surprised that they decided to mess with that. That extra 2 seconds is actually kind of a big deal because you can get at least one or two, even three chained abilities off in the span of those 2 seconds if you're timing it right. But obviously, most players are probably not even going to think about it like that. So I was a little bit surprised that they messed with Draconic Discipline because I never thought the Dragon Queen was really that big of a deal. But there you go on that. Brightwing getting a little bit of help as well. Her Polymorph has been reduced by 2 seconds. Pretty cool. Mana cost also reduced. I like that. Anytime we see mana cost reductions for supports, I'm all about that. Being an ex-Malfurion player, I know the woes and trials and tribulations of having no mana during and throughout the early game to mid-game stages, so that's a good change for Brightwing. Same goes for Lili as well. The Health Restore from Cloud Serpent at the base level has been increased by a whole lot. So those of you Lili players who love to troll your enemy, your teammates, and going for the Cloud Serpent builds, but you're looking at nuking, at least you're going to have a little bit more healing prowess on the board there instead of just, you know, making everyone sad that you're not a healing Lili. Level 1, they did a lot of things to the Wind Serpent. The cooldown reduction has also been messed with. Same thing goes for Serpent Sidekick. Safety Sprint duration has been increased from 2 to 3 seconds. Again, that's a big survivability change for Lili, who is already sort of a difficult healer to catch up to if she ends up going out there with her passive. And then Let's Go, the range has been increased, and Gale Force has been increased as well. Sure, why not? On to Lucio. Lucio has gotten a little bit of a nerf here. Again, it's surprising that they were even looking at Lucio, but his healing per second for his E ability, Amp It Up, has been reduced at the base level by 6. Not that big of a deal. So, there you go on that. Sorry, Lucio players. I happen to not be a Lucio player, so I'm not too keen about any Lucio changes. You really don't see him that much, at least not at my level anyway. Stukov is going to get a little bit of a nerf on the mana restoration from one good spread. For those of you who are going for the Q builds for Stukov, you're not gonna be able to spam it as much. But again, I don't think that this is really a big deal from a meta standpoint. This is just overall early game tweaks that you have to worry about. So he's not too powerful in the early game, but late game, it's not really gonna affect him. That's how most of these changes go, by the way, for balance changes. Now let's talk about Artanis, because Artanis did actually get a pretty surprising increase of damage here with Chrono Surge. Chrono Surge is one of the ones that I will use a lot for the Prism on his E ability, and the attack speed bonus has been increased from 50 to 75%. Now, you gotta remember, if Artanis is attacking 75% faster for a short duration, that means that he's able to reset the cooldown on Shield Overcharge for pretty much the rest of the game after level 7. And that's pretty darn nice. As someone who plays Artanis fairly often, I'm very interested to see how this build goes into the Infinite Shield build that I do over and over again on Artanis here on the channel. And if you haven't seen those videos, by the way, just search my videos and you're bound to find it, or you could probably just put it in YouTube. Let's just search for Cynvicta Infinite Shield build and you'll be able to find it there for Artanis. Spell Armor getting help a little bit from the Phase Bulwark. Same thing goes for Templar Zeal. The cooldown reduction has been increased from 150% to 200% at the level 13. So those of you who like using those Q abilities, hey, there you go. That Zealot Rush is going to be a lot faster to use for Artanis. So good changes for Artanis. Surprising changes, because I didn't think that he was actually in need of anything. But that's why I don't work as a balanced designer for Blizzard, because I'd be terrible at it. I probably would have gotten fired the moment that I stepped in the building. On to D.Va, the basic attack damage has been increased from 21 to 24. Yay. There you go, D.Va. I guess. Anyway, Garrosh. Alright, let's talk about Garrosh. As you saw from the thumbnail, Garrosh has been completely gutted as far as his kit goes, and the way that he plays, it's no longer the old style of Garrosh. And if you're wondering what I'm talking about, if you're just looking at the thumbnail thinking like, oh, this... like, here we go. Like, this doesn't really seem all that bad. Well, let's talk about it. So his base health increased, has been increased by a little bit. Health regeneration increased. Yay, who really cares about either of those? Groundbreaker. Groundbreaker no longer pulls enemy heroes to Garrosh. You get that? I'll read it again. Groundbreaker no longer pulls enemy heroes to Garrosh. That was the core design of the Q ability for Garrosh, and his and overall philosophy surrounding Garrosh was to be this force that simply made enemy heroes get pulled out of positions that they want to, set up kills for your team. It's what made Garrosh Garrosh, and now they have removed that. And you can probably already tell where I'm going with this, but I want to keep an open mind. I don't want to be all negative on it, even though even if I really dislike the change on it, let's give the benefit of the doubt here. So instead, Groundbreaker now knocks enemies' heroes into the air, stunning them for 3/4 of a second and then slowing them by 30% for 2 seconds. This is supposed to be a little bit of an olive branch for those of you who are still, you know, ready to man the pitchforks and the torches and go after Blizzard for killing our Garrosh. A knockup and a stun, I mean, Garrosh is going to be viable in stun comps, I suppose. By the way, they have not changed the way the Wrecking Ball works. They're simply just destroying Groundbreaker. And whether or not this will allow you to still get some Wrecking Ball throws, I don't know yet. I haven't played the new Garrosh yet, but I'm going to try it out later on today. Maybe on stream, maybe not, and we'll see how bad or how good it is. Talent tooltips for Warbreaker, blah, 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 have been updated. Wrecking Ball, the cooldown has been reduced from 16 to 14 seconds. Mana cost has been reduced. Yay. I mean, that's not really all that much of a compensation for the loss of Groundbreaker. And level 16, the Mortal Combo. Cooldown reduction granted from Wrecking Ball decreased from 10 to 8 seconds. That's in direct response to them reducing the base cooldown of Wrecking Ball. And the window of time to throw enemies has been increased from 2 to 3 seconds. Yay. Alright, so let's talk about Blizzard's statement about the change, and then I will give you my overall thoughts on it and where I see Garrosh going from here. So Blizzard says, while he is well balanced in regard to his win rate, Garrosh has been widely considered more punishing than other warriors compared to the amount of counterplay he offers. While we love his playstyle and the epic moments that he can create, we wanted to reduce the amount of frustration he can cause opponents. We've added a window of time between being hit by Groundbreaker and being thrown into the enemy team, which should help players have more of an opportunity to outplay him. We're also looking at other heroes who are lacking in counterplay and are overly frustrating to play against, and are planning on making similar changes to them in the future. Cough, cough, Valyra, cough, cough, Garrosh. So, where does this... What does all this mean from a long-term standpoint in regards to Heroes of Storm for me? I think that this is a worrying change, because I've seen this happen a couple of times with other heroes in the game where it's not really a one-trick pony mechanic, because Garrosh is certainly not a one-trick pony, but it's his best trick. And if you take away the pony's best trick, you're going to be left with someone with a fairly dull and uninteresting pony, and that's, no one wants to have that. And no, I'm not talking about, you know what I mean, it's metaphorical, come on now. So this is worrying to me, because This is showing that Blizzard is willing to completely gut the functionality of a mechanic that they themselves have introduced and touted and advertised for Hero in order to maintain this sort of level of fun. It's sort of an ambiguous value, I guess. It's hard to say what it is. I mean, it's made up. You know, some people really derive fun different ways in the game, and for me personally, the entire appeal of Garrosh was the fact that you are able to displace many, many, many enemy heroes during team fights. You can throw them over gates, you can throw them over walls, you can throw them into like stuns, that sort of thing. That's what Garrosh does. Now that he doesn't have that, he just has a ranged stun and a knockup. I mean, that might be nice if most heroes weren't unstoppable during, like, say, their channeling or anything like that. Like, you're certainly not going to be able to use this and stop, like, Diablo, or you're not going to be able to stop Cassia. It's a worrisome trend to see that we're going to have one of our more unique mechanics just get completely gutted from the inside out. And, you know, and Blizzard themselves says that, you know, they stated that they are that Garrosh is well-balanced regarding his win rate. Usually, historically speaking, the Heroes of the Storm balancing came around the idea of someone's win rate being way out of whack. Like, that is the metric that Blizzard sort of measures their balances around. Usually, again, this is just historically speaking, not 100% certainty, but most of the time that we've seen this, you'll see Heroes balancing go all... They always focus around the win rate. If one Hero's particular win rate is way too high, they realize that there needs to be an adjustment. If someone's getting banned too much, they need to see where the adjustment is, that sort of thing. And I think that the latter here is probably what spurred this sort of idea that Blizzard needed to change Garrosh from the base level of his only really unique mechanic that he had. We've seen armor on other people. We've seen displacement from other people, like, you know, and by displacement, I mean Wrecking Ball, because, and don't tell me that sort of thing does not exist for other heroes. Look at Ariel, look at Diablo, look at Lieutenant Morales, look at anyone who can force an enemy hero out of position. That is Garrosh has that. Now Garrosh just has a stun and a knockup, just like most of the other heroes in the game. You know, that it might as well be a root at that point. You know, with certain similarities, with differences, I mean, because obviously a root you can still cast, whereas if you're knocked up or stunned, you can't exactly cast. But you get what I'm saying, though. He's just another CC warrior now. So it's really, I'm super disappointed because I love Garrosh. And, you know, I do think that something needed to be changed because I hated not being able to play Garrosh in Hero League because he's always first ban. But at the same time, I don't think that this was the correct way to do it. I'm not here. I'm not getting paid on YouTube. Haha. I'm also not getting paid to second guess Blizzard. You know, and Blizzard balancing it will always know better than myself personally on this stuff. But I don't think that this was the right way to go as far as fixing Garrosh. He didn't need to be fixed. He just needed to be tweaked a little bit because he was always first ban. And I think that's a good thing that a hero is automatically first banned all the time. Even though I hate it, I still think it's good because that shows that the hero is widely respected and is well designed, and the community recognizes that. Like, look, you cannot let people play Garrosh. If you do, you're in a lot of trouble if that person knows what they're doing. You know, so if you ask me, well, if that's not the answer, Sinvicta, what is the answer then? I can't tell you. I don't know what the answer would be, but I certainly know that I would not have ever suggested stopping Groundbreaker. I mean, the thing that I would have said, this is personally what I would have done. If you held me to it, if you said, no, you cannot leave this room until you give us what you would have done, then I would say I would have reduced the range on Groundbreaker for it to pull. So, for example, I would say take the current range, or at least the old range now, of Groundbreaker, and you have the outer edge of the Q ability. That is where Garrosh pulls. I would say reduce that by 50%. Force Garrosh to get closer to his targets so he could still throw them and he could still pull them out of position and still stop, you know, cast and that sort of thing, but still giving him that pull there. So maybe even reduce it to melee range. I mean, I don't know. That's what I would have suggested, something like that. Still, just let him pull people, just not as far of a length as the old one. But again, I didn't feel that there was anything wrong with it. That might be a little bit of bias coming out because Garrosh was widely considered, and I'm on record saying that he was the most powerful character in the game because of this one mechanic that they've now completely stripped away. So, long story short, I don't agree with the change. I think that something better probably could have been proposed. Either by the community or, you know, who knows what sort of thought process Blizzard was running through when they decided to do this. Whether or not this is going to flat out kill Garrosh, I don't know. Again, I'm not a sage, I'm not an oracle, I'm not a future teller. I just don't know. One thing I do know is that it's Garrosh is just another CC warrior now. It's kind of sad, so. Anyway, let me know what your thoughts are down below. Again, I still applaud Blizzard for looking at all the heroes and doing all of the balancing that they've done. Regardless if I agree with it or not, they're still in tune with the community. They're still paying attention to what's going on with the heroes, and they're still able to identify where the problems are. Maybe if they don't handle it the right way that you like it, well, try to keep an open mind, and maybe you'll learn to accept it. So, it just sucks if you're a Garrosh player. So thank you for watching, everyone. Hope you enjoyed it. As always, I'll see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody!